This husband and wife team based in Garden Grove, Cali, are going to be making a killing investing in Section 8 rentals, and it doesn't cost them a ton of money. Anybody can do what they did and are doing, and I'm showing you how today. This is your show. This is the show where I work for you directly, taking your needs. I'm going through the MLS, and I'm trying to find the best possible deal for you guys. Put down 25%. That's the perfect way to buy this. That's why real estate investing is the greatest industry in the world. Welcome to the show, man. I am James Wise. I said welcome to the show, man. I mean man and ladies out there, right? Because today we're doing a little real estate with a man and a lady. My folks, Tim and Tina, husband-wife team, right? Working together. I think, never mind. This is like, they're simpatico, man. They are working together, knocking out a family business. Going to be making a ton of money in the rental real estate space, right? Working with a ton of Section 8 investment properties, right? And they're out there in Garden Grove. And you know what they're doing? You know what Tim and Tina are doing, folks? They're doing things a little differently than you might be thinking, right? Because you might be sitting there with your lovely significant other, right? You might be like, man, me and you, babe, we could totally invest in real estate, but we don't have $10 million to buy all the crazy expensive real estate in Garden Grove, man. How do we do it? We're just regular folks. We're just a regular couple, right? How do we get started in real estate? Don't worry, folks. Tim and Tina are in the same position. They're not super millionaires, right? They don't got that silver spoon money, right? So what do? They're smart. They understand the real estate business. They understand that the real estate in Garden Grove and pretty much all of California is highly expensive, right? We live in this great country called the United States of America, right? And in the middle, we got a median house value. There we go. That's the word I was looking for, right? California, it's way the hell above that, right? Other places in America, way below that. That's where we want to invest. Ding, 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 right? Anybody can do it, right? So Tim and Tina hooked up with me because my company specializes in that. We help people from Cali invest in low-cost markets. When you Google, like, the best cash flow markets of the USA, the markets that pop up, these are the kinds of markets we focus on. And today I'm helping them get a duplex in Cleveland, the Cleveland market, I should say. It's not actually in the city of Cleveland. It's about 30 minutes west, right? The whole Northeast Ohio area. And, folks, if you're in Garden Grove, you're going to be shocked at the amount of money you can actually buy multifamily real estate for in other parts of America, and you'll be shocked to see how high the price-to-rent ratio is. And, oh, guess what? Not to mention the landlord-tenant laws, much simpler than what you're dealing with in California, right? And my team, we're handling all the on-the-ground work. I got a duplex for you, Tim, that you and Tina are going to love. Perfect for cash-paying tenants, perfect for Section 8 tenants, very easy on the budget. Let's jump into the numbers right now. Man, I hate those other real estate gurus out there. Those real estate gurus that lead you guys to believe fairy tales, lead you guys to believe in magic, lead you guys to think that there's gonna be genies granting your wishes if you buy their course or their program. Like there's gonna be hot girls in bikinis just popping out. That's not the real life of a real estate investor. And here on HoltonWise TV, we give it to you straight. Welcome back, folks. Let's pull up the numbers, man. This is what matters, right? This is the property. Looks kind of quirky. It's a two-family home, up, down. What I love about this, and we'll get to the numbers because the numbers are what really matters, but what I really love here, and it directly correlates with the numbers, is the fact that this is a 3-1, 3-1, okay? Normally, in this market, we're dealing with 2-1s, 2-1s, right? Two beds, one bath, each unit. This one is a 3-bath, 1-unit, and that's going to allow us some serious money, 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 right? Here's what we have. Look at that rent roll right there. $775 and $900, right? $1,675 comes in, right? $20,100, which, by the way, as you see the address, it's 316 4th Street, Elyria, right? Here's the thing. Elyria, as well as a large other portion of the Cleveland area, mostly has two ones, okay? Most duplexes have a total of four beds and two baths, and we're seeing $750 in rent. This thing is special because you have those extra two bedrooms. Now, I will say this. I think $900 is honestly a little optimistic, right? I feel like it's hard to regularly get that much rent, even though there's three beds. But I also feel like $775 is honestly kind of low, right? So in reality, I would say $850, I think, is the sweet spot, right? I think they rented the one unit for a little bit less than they should have. They rented the other unit for a little bit more than is reasonable to expect all the time, right? So I would say $850, right, which would be $1,700 a month is what we will normally expect, right? But we'll go ahead and just run the numbers here based on what they have because it's very close to the $1,700, which I'd project for the long haul, right? They got $1,675 coming in. So let's just roll with that. But again, I don't anticipate getting $900 very often, but I also anticipate going above $775, right? So of the $1,675 that comes in, I anticipate us spending approximately $825, leaving a pure NOI of $849.25 or a yearly net return of $10,191, right? As far as what the unit looks like itself, it's nothing like amazing, right? We have just like hardwoods throughout, okay? Pretty simple stuff. It's kind of a dated kitchen. Honestly, at the next turnover, we'd probably want to update this a little bit so we can make sure we get that $850 easily. It kind of goes back to the what's the deal with that $900 tenant, right? Like, why are they paying $900? Why are they paying $900 for a dated unit, right? As you can see, these are all the photos they took prior to the tenants moving in, folks. It is fully occupied by those two. When you see a tenant paying a little bit above market rate, right? Like, I could understand why the one tenant pays $775, right? Market rate's $850, but it's a little dated. Okay, that makes sense, right? But why is this other tenant paying more, right? They're paying $900 for a market rate unit that's about $850, and it's a little dated. What's going on there? What you have to understand is you could usually get any tenant to pay any amount, honestly. Like, you could get people to pay above market rate, okay? But what that usually means is there's an issue, right? If they're a good, solid tenant, there's a bunch of market rate apartments they have to choose from. If you're getting above market rate from that tenant, you might only be renting to that tenant because they don't have the ability to rent another place, right? That could be someone with something in their background, right? They can't get approved at other places. So you should be a little leery when a seller's selling you a property with above market rate tenants in there and it's dated, right? Like, okay, if this was just like the most badass, like dope looking unit and they were getting an extra 50 spot out of that tenant, sweet. But it's not, it's dated, right? So just remember that little thing of caution. All that said though, I don't think it's a bad deal. I still think we should move forward with it. They're asking $120. I think we should try to pick it up at $115, knowing that we may or may not have a problem tenant. But here's the thing. It's three beds, one bath in each unit in a solid high C, low B grade neighborhood, right? Elyria, honestly, I like investing in Elyria more than the actual city of Cleveland at this point because I feel like the city in Elyria is much easier to deal with. We don't have the new lead-based paint regulations rolling out in Elyria like we do in Cleveland. So I really dig Elyria, but I just want you to have eyes wide open understanding that one tenant could potentially be an issue. But it's still, in my opinion, worth that risk to try to pick it up at 115 because of the fact that you get those 3-1 units, right? There is not a lot of 3-1 units out there in this market. Probably 98% of the duplexes I sell here in the Cleveland market are going to be 2-1s, right? So that third one, that's a nice premium. And we're not really paying much of a premium on top of what we pay for a normal 2-1, right? Usually we're paying about $100K for those, right? So we're only paying a $15K premium. So even with that tenant in the dated units, not a big deal. I still think it makes most sense, right? And if we finance it, you only put down $28,750. The bank kicks in $86,250. That should project out at a 20.2% cash-on-cash return. And, of course, my team will handle everything. We will handle the property management. We will handle the maintenance. If that $900 tenant turns out to be a problem, we will be the people evicting him. We will be the people updating the unit after we evict that tenant. getting you new tenants, rocking and rolling. This thing is a long-term cash cow, solid neighborhood. Love the extra bedrooms. I think we got to move on this one and move on it quickly. My suggested price is $115.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to HoltonWise TV for more financial information, education, and entertainment.